quick word about New Zealand, a vast fantasy world that was invented by J.R.R. Tolkien to be the filming location for The Lord of the Rings.
Cheeky British toff John Oliver has gone too far.
I'd like to talk about a very important election there. Not their general election, which happened 3 weeks ago and no one noticed.
Not content with crapping on Aotearoa's bird of the century competition from his ivory perch.
But obviously there's no way this little flightless freak could ever win anything legitimately except maybe a ferret lookalike contest.
He last night incited a global campaign of election interference by exploiting a loophole in our system.
The good news is New Zealand's contest is not actually restricted to just New Zealand.
Using foreign media money, John Oliver is trying to get a joke bird elected as our bird of the century.
I'm talking, of course, about the Pūtekiteki. Even its name is fun to say. Pūtekiteki. Pūtekiteki. It feels like your tongue is tap dancing.
The voting process has already been disrupted.
Since the show aired last night, I think we've had an additional 50,000 votes. And just to put that in perspective, last year the total votes for Bird of the Year was just under 52,000. It's certainly blown up. My poor old web team and the team involved in running Bird of the Century haven't had an awful lot of sleep.
Don't let its Rayo name fool you. This thing is also known all over the world as the Grebe. And if you're a floating voter, this is what you should know. It's also half Australian. Our bird democracy is under threat. We Kiwis need to stop the steal. We Kiwis need to vote Kiwi.
If the team of 5 million can band together to vote for Kiwi, then we've got this.
The Kiwi is often sidelined for Bird of the Year, but the Kiwi is the only choice, the obvious choice, for Bird of the Century. John Oliver may have spent HBO's entire budget for his campaign. Well, we can use all the cash TV3 gave us for ours. John Oliver says he wants to eat all the other Bird of the Century candidates alive before throwing them up in a ball of feathers. That includes our national bird. We won't let that happen. So whoever you vote for in Bird of the Century, make sure you reject the Pūtekiteki. Real name, John Oliver's Grebe. And keep it Kiwi, New Zealand. Stop it. New Zealand.
Well, kia ora, hey, welcome along to the project, everyone. Claire Chittum's here tonight. Claire. Shots fired, eh? What do you make of it all?
Wow, I love John Oliver. I'm a John Oliver fan, but I just don't know if I can get on board with being a New Zealander and voting for a bird that I have never heard of before.
Yeah.
Hand on heart, sorry, bird watchers.
Get your grebe and get out of here, yeah. Oliver.
I love it. He's teasing us. He's teasing us, which is a great New Zealand thing. He gets us, and I love that. And a great publicity, of course, and it was an incredible watch. The money he spent would have saved the show. But he... I still don't want him subverting our Bird of the Century.
Right.
So I think all the votes that come from overseas should be disallowed, disqualified.
Hang on.
Oh.
That's very Trumpian of you to see election going one way and then try and disqualify the votes.
I think he's the one being Trumpian.
Maybe.
And also, a bat won it 2 years ago. I think we kissed goodbye to any sort of rules, didn't we?
I will say, I've never voted in Bird of the Year before, but because of what he's done, hang on a minute, maybe I need to get my vote in.
I'm just happy for the birds. They're getting so much attention at the moment. That's what Bird of the Year is all about. Obscure birds like the grebe getting a international stage.
Yeah.